Hey Java developers! In this video, we're going to walk through some of the key concepts and features for using Jlink. If you're not familiar with Jlink, it's a command line tool for creating custom runtime images containing only the modules your Java application needs. This reduces the size of your Java application and improves security as you're reducing your attack surface area. There are some additional operational benefits which might matter depending upon your use case. We'll cover those a bit later in the video. For more background on the technical details of Jlink, check out my Stackwalker video on Jlink. In this video, we will cover basics of creating a custom runtime image, using JDeps to find which modules you'll need, adding non-JDK modules to custom images, creating your own explicit modules and adding them to a custom image, and options for further customizing the images created with Jlink. You'll find all the code examples for this video at this GitHub repo. Okay, we have a lot to cover, so let's get started. So let's begin with a simple Hello World program to cover the basics of using Jlink. To create a custom runtime image for this program, we'd call Jlink, use the option add modules and pass it java.base, and the option output and pass the value hello Jlink image. This will be the name of the image we create. Execute the command, and after a few moments, a new image is created in the directory we ran the command from. If we explore the hello Jlink image directory, we see it has a similar structure to the JDK. However, looking into subdirectories, we see it has a lot less content. For example, bin only contains Java and the key tool. We can use hello Jlink image bin Java to run hello world. If we attempted to run helloworld.java as a single file source code application, a feature added in JDK 11, it would fail. This is because hello Jlink image doesn't include Java C, which is in the JDK.compiler module. However, the trade-off is the hello Jlink image is much smaller than your standard JDK 21 install, only 50 megabytes to JDK 21's 329 megabytes. Though only including java.base, this is the most ideal case for Jlink. Let's start adding to the complexity. Few programs merely depend upon java.base. If we try running this slightly more complex application, get website with the hello Jlink image we created in the previous section, it will fail, throwing class not found exceptions, as this program has references to classes outside the java.base module. Manually looking up which modules are required isn't a scalable solution. That's where JDeps comes in, another command line tool included in the JDK for analyzing dependencies. Running JDeps on getWebsite.class returns a table. At the top of it shows the three classes getWebsite is using: java.base, java.logging, and java.net.http. Below that, the output shows how that was calculated. Adding the option print modules deps produces a comma separated list of the modules, which can be copied and pasted into the add module option used when creating a Jlink image. Using this new image to execute get website allows the program to execute successfully. So we have covered the trivial hello world use case, a bit more advanced example of resolving some JDK modules and then adding them to an image. But as much as I love the JDK, most Java applications have dependencies outside of the JDK. In this program, we are using string utils, part of the Apache Commons Lang 3 library, to reverse a string. Apache's Commons Lang 3 is also an explicit module, which can be verified with the jar command. Like in this command, jar-d libs commons lang 3 release 21, as it's a multi-release jar. And this produces the module name org Apache Commons Lang 3. You can also visit Kristen Stein's GitHub repo to see a list of popular Maven libraries and their module status. Using JDeps again with the command JDeps module path libs multi-release 21 foo reverse string.class, we get the expected output of depending upon java.base and org Apache Commons Lang 3. We can include org Apache Commons Lang 3 in an image just like any JDK module. By adding it to the module path with the module path option, when creating a Jlink image like in this command, Jlink module path libs, add modules, java.base, org apache commons lang 3, and then the output of the image we want to create. Using this image to execute our application, we see some of the additional operational benefits of Jlink, as we didn't need to set a class path like we would normally need to if using the standard JDK. However, we can go even farther with this. Of course, you can create your own explicit modules as well by creating a moduleinfo.java file. In module info, you describe the module you'd wish to create, in this case, the foo module, that requires org apache commons lang 3. Note, java.base is implicitly required by all modules, so does not need to be explicitly declared in module info. You can then create a module file with the jmod tool, like in this command, jmod create class path mod foo.jmod. We can then add this module to a Jlink image, just like we did with commons lang in the previous section. Jlink module path, libs and mods, add modules, java.base, org apache commons lang 3, food, and then the output image. And then we can run the application. We can make it even easier to run an application in a Jlink image by adding a launcher. To add a launcher to a Jlink image, in this Jlink command, add the launcher option, provide a name, in this case app, the module name where the main class is located, and fully qualified path to the main class. Like in this example, Jlink add modules, module path, and then the launcher app equals foo, foo.reverse string, output launcher. If we reference the launcher app in the bin directory, we'd need only to pass in the string value we wanted to be reversed. If you're distributing an application to customers, using Jlink can create a much more streamlined and less error-prone process, as you can distribute both the runtime and application as a single artifact. So, I kept all these examples relatively simple. However, if you'd like to see a more complex example involving build tools like Maven and frameworks like Spring Boot, or something else involving how to incorporate Jlink into your development process, let us know in the comments, and we can look at making a video covering those use cases. So far, we have covered how to make a basic Jlink custom image, but Jlink has some options for further customizing the images it creates. Much of this behavior is provided through the plugins, though the plugin API is in public. Story for another day. You can get a full list of available plugins with their descriptions with Jlink list plugins. The two we will focus on is Generate CDS Archive and Compress. I covered CDS in a Stackwalker video a few months ago. Check it out if you'd like to know more. But in short, CDS can improve the startup performance of an application by creating a pre-processed archive of the classes an application will load on startup. Jlink can add a CDS archive to a custom image with the Generate Archive option, which takes no parameters. If you were to run the application again, there's a small improvement in execution time. Another customization option would be Compress. There are 9 levels of compression offered. The default is Zip 6. If you were to create an image using Zip 9, the size of the image you create is quite a bit smaller. Of course, this comes at a cost of performance from the additional decompression that needs to be done. Jlink and modules have been a somewhat overlooked feature by Java developers since their introduction in JDK 9. But as we saw in this video, they can offer some nice benefits like improved security, performance, and user experience. However, the story for Jlink isn't over. Indeed, it looks to be getting even more interesting. Project Leiden, an OpenJDK project with the goals of improving startup and time to pre-performance, is starting to pick up steam. It's likely Jlink will be a key tool for incorporating features that come out of Project Leiden. Building operational knowledge with Jlink now could put your organization in a good position to take advantage of Project Leiden features as they reach maturity. So definitely be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow inside.java so you can follow as Project Leiden features are announced. If you enjoyed this video, leave a like. If you have questions, please ask them in the comments. Until next time, happy coding!